Hello everyone, in this session I'll be explaining the design of canal. So the design of canal can be done according to different theories, but I'm considering lazy silt theory here. And according to lazy silt theory, the equation for bed slope is given by S is equal to F into F to the power of 5 by 3 and divided by 3340 into Q to the power of 1 by 6, and where S is equal to canal bed slope, and it can be taken equal to 1 in 2000 for gravity flow. That is, one meter drop for every 2 kilometers will be the drop. Okay, 1 meter will be the drop for 2 kilometers. So you can take silt factor for the channels equal to 1.3, and Q is equal to discharge in meter cube per second, and then the discharge equation is given by according to Lewis's theory. That is, this rearrangement, if you do, it will be this way, and if you substitute, you will get 0.63 cumex or meter cube per second will be the discharge in the channel or canal. And the maximum scouring velocity for which is given by the formula V is equal to Qf square divided by 140 to the power of 1 by 6. If you substitute it, you will get velocity of water which is flowing in the canal as 0.44 meter per second. So for trapezoidal canal, assuming 1 is to 1 slope, okay, this slope, 1 horizontal to 1 vertical, if you assume, K will be equal to 1, and we know the by formula Q is equal to AV, we can calculate A is equal to Q by V. So 0.63 by 0.4 will give you 1.43 area, will be the flow of flow area. So assuming the depth of the flow as 0.75 meter in the canal, then we can able to calculate the base width, which is given by 1.43 is equal to area is equal to BD plus KD square. This is the formula for a canal, is a trapezoidal channel with the slope, okay. And if you substitute the depth as well as area, we can able to get B, and which is equal to 1.25 meter. So the base width is 1.25 meter, and the 0.75 meter will be the height, the flow. But assuming freeboard of 0.5 meter, so the total depth of the canal will be equal to 0.5 plus 0.75, which is equal to 1.5 meter. So this will be the dimensions of the canal. So having these values, I have drawn a typical cross section for the canal. So these will be the cross sections of the canal. This is 1 is to 1 slope we will maintain, and base width 1.25, height is 1.25, and on the sides you can minimum you should have the soil which is equal to 2 meter, and 2 meter is the top width, and you can provide 1 is to 2 slope for the soil beds other sides, okay. So this is for typical cross section which is coming under filling. So if the ground level is below the canal level, so that will be called as filling. Whereas if the existing ground level, if it is little above the filling, above the canal bed level, it will be called partially filled and partially cutting, okay. And this will arise whenever there is the ground level is in between, okay. And if that depends upon the bed slope, sometimes it will be some part cutting and partly filling. I'll show you. And so typical cross section under cutting, so entire, if the ground level is above the, you know, at the level of top crest level, then that will be called as, it will be under cutting, okay, cross section which will be under cutting. So these are the typical cross sections. I'll be sharing these with you, so you can you have to do modifications in your designs appropriately, okay. And I think this design will remain same for everybody. You can use the same typical cross sections and prepare the drawings, drawing sheets. And this is the typical cross section for the bund which I have already shared, and now I'll be sharing these typical cross sections of canals, right. And in the next video I'll be showing you how to place this cross section, typical cross section of the canal on the existing ground level of the canal alignment at every cross section, and we'll be able to find the earthwork required for the canal construction. Right, that will be done in the next video. So till then, I'll be sharing the report also. This report also from the design of dam to design of canal. So depending upon the RLs, each batch can change appropriately their RLs. Okay, here. Depending upon those RLs, you just change those RLs and update your report. Okay, and also this at the end, this will be consisting of reservoir capacity and earthbound calculations, the earthwork for the proposed bund calculation, and all these things are just temporary values which you need to update. Okay, depending upon your cross section areas which you're going to get. These values will be differing. Okay, so all these values will differ and you have to update. Right, yeah. So I'll stop at this stage. Thank you.